Oh! What?
So we're in Port O'Connor, Texas. Just got here. It's about 9 o'clock. Been traveling all day. Weather's a little rough right now, but we're hoping for some good weather tomorrow. Go with Kevin, get some quick fly fishing tips done videos, and hopefully hit the water on Wednesday. So
see
how the water is. You know, it's going to be a little... Yeah, we got a hurricane coming our way right now, if you don't know what's going on with the weather. So we're hoping for good weather Thursday, Friday. That's what's projecting. So tomorrow to get some stuff done, meet Kevin, hopefully have a great day. So.
That's how you make a pizza, Rob.
We are in Port O'Connor, Texas. Kevin just came and picked us up and we went over the production shoot list today. We're looking for some good shots, good places to go do some intro videos to fly fishing, tie some knots and do some great things. So hopefully you're gonna find a good spot and get some videos done today.
If we get a lot of blue, we're gonna immediately, where we're gonna fish,
right over here.
Just on the other side of that island.
Okay, gotcha.
That dog ended up having to get cut out of the vehicle.
Oh, wow,
lot for
really?
Lot. They cut the dog out of the vehicle, and then the dog took off. And it was about 40 miles from here. Long story short, the volunteer fire department, the police department, us, got a group together and searched for that dog for 2 days and found it.
Wow, really? Yeah. Where?
About 3 miles from where the wreck was. Up under a culvert, and
really?
This farmer who had word of it saw the dog just stick her head out for a second, and she wouldn't come out of the culvert. My dog is her best friend, so we got my dog and put him at the end of the culvert, and she came out of the culvert.
Hopefully the weather gets a little bit better. We're still dealing with these 20 to 30 mile per hour winds, so hopefully we can get out there later today, but tomorrow it's looking much better, and hopefully go catch some tarpon and some redfish. So catch you guys soon. Like to get a hold of Thomas or even Kevin, you can visit at ktdiaries.com and get a hold of them and learn more about this. Catch you guys later.
You know, when you're using a fly that floats on the surface, it's really important to understand how the fish is seeing it. I mean, we can see the fly here, we can see all the colors, we can see what we think the shape is, but remember the fish is under the water looking up at the surface, so he's actually seeing more of a silhouette of the fly. And the brighter the sun is, the less color he sees and the more just silhouette he'll see.
Driving back from our first day. Weather conditions weren't too great, so we couldn't get on the water. We're doing a little bit of a hurricane mess. Got about 20 to 30 mile per hour winds, but luckily we made the most of it. We got about 7 to 8 videos done about fly fishing, the tips, how to tie a leader, how to tie a fly, all that good stuff. Kevin's awesome. We're heading back to the place right now. Hopefully go grab a beer with him later. Weather should be much better tomorrow. Should be actually go out and hopefully catch a fish. It'll be my first time, so it's gonna be a challenge, but I think we got it. Day two, we're heading out to the water finally. The weather turned out to be much better today than expected. The winds are down, I think below 15, which is what we were looking for. We're about to go head out into the water, got the coffee ready.
Much better this morning. Just can't feel the wind here, but it's blowing a little bit, but it's much better than yesterday. I'm
steep ramp. I can't get it off. Of the redfish, the much maligned black drum, ain't that gold spoon fly, excuse me. Oh,
all right, one more time.
two for the price of one.
Exactly.
How can you tell the difference when they're in the water? They look the same to me.
Redfish,
yeah.
If we see a bit more redfish, you'll be able to see. I mean, redfish do look red in the water most of the time.
Woo! Nice.
Griff, you want to come up here? Quickly.
Yay, yay, yay.
Woo! 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 Woo!
All right, buddy.
Kissing.
Kiss him.
Nice!
Yes!
That's an oversized fish almost, if not totally.
Let me get the... not hesitate to eat that fly.
Yeah, he was all about it. He investigated and ate.
Here you go.
That's a pretty fish.
Success!
Woo! Oh.
Yeah!
Way to go, Bunda.
Woo!
Last day, beautiful sunny conditions, no wind, looking like a good day to catch some fish.
I was just waiting on the hit there.
We are out here in the Gulf of Mexico. We have been trying to catch a tarpon for about 3 hours now, and these guys have been biting hard. Kevin over here had one hook, and then, you know, he broke the line because he was too strong. We're gonna keep going. We got a couple more hours of this, and hopefully we catch one right now. But these guys are being stingy with us right now, so hopefully we got one in the next few hours.
Heartbroken. I mean, that's actually, I'm sure that I had two hooks. Broke one off, didn't come tight on the other one. Thomas had a couple of opportunities too, and man, on tarpon, you just can't pass up your opportunities. Yeah, this is our return migration. The fish are all going back to Mexico now. Here we are in mid-September, and so we're just in the later part of the season and what we call the return migration. We happen to have caught, there's been probably 100 fish that we've been over already this morning, and they're happy fish. Just unhappy fishermen right now.
Oh, here. Big fish.
Nice. Yeah.
Oh!
Oh! What?
I wanted that fish because that was my closest one yet. Man, God damn.
Good job. Looks like a, man, they just came out of nowhere. Literally just appeared.
Thank you.
TV, buddy, talk. Get your cigar out of your mouth. Say something good. All
right. There you go.
Woo!
On the green spoon fly. Let me see the fly.
You got the green spoon fly?
It's about the only thing you can use when there's this much grass in the water, as you can see the grass coming off of it.
That's a freaking beautiful fish, man.
Well, he's about a 24-inch, 25-inch redfish, slot fish, meaning you could keep it if you wanted to eat one. And with this grass, you just got to land that fly, I mean, right in front of their nose, or you got to have grass on it. And they're not going to eat it, but that one ate really good. And I bet he swims off very healthy.
We are unfortunately wrapping up our time here in Port O'Connor, but I wanted to give you a rewind of everything we had to deal with. So day one, man, did we have some weather to deal with, Kevin. Couldn't even get out on the water. That hurricane was hitting us. We had, what, 20 to 30 mile per hour winds.
Oh, God.
It was something like Kevin said.
The North Atlantic Ocean out
there. Oh, man, the water was brown. I mean, no sun it out. But fortunately, we were able to get a lot of videos done in some studios and out in the, what was it, sanctuary. Mm-hmm. Very cool private residence that Kevin was able to show us. Second day, we're able to get on the water in the morning. We hit a crazy thunderstorm for about an hour or two. I mean, man, I was so wet. It looked like I had just got jumped in the ocean and got it. It was something out of this world. We go to get lunch. We come back out. All of a sudden, it's 99 degrees, and it is freaking hot, guys. Guys, I've never sweated so much just from fishing. I mean, again, I was drenched again, dried up and then drenched again. We were able to actually get on a couple redfish. What else did we get on that day? We
got black drum.
A black drum.
It's called a black drum, which is actually harder to catch on a fly than a redfish.
Because they're not that smart, I heard.
No, we're not going to do, no, we can't do that to a fish. They're just not as aggressive.
As aggressive, that's how we're going to fish.
There you go.
So we're able to catch on some fish, get some really great B-roll and just some drone shots. I mean, guys, Port O'Connor is just absolutely beautiful. Once that water started to clear up, it was amazing. Well, yesterday, we actually got in some great fish. We were out early in the morning, great sunrise. Kevin here, unfortunately, didn't get the tarpon that he wanted after the four bites, and he ripped one off. Guys acting like me out there. But we were able to get, Tom was able to get one out of the air. We got some great footage that I hope you guys will be able to see that. And we actually caught a really awesome redfish.
Caught another nice redfish yesterday.
Right in the water, guys, like I said, it was crystal green. It was blue. Everything Kevin was talking about earlier, it was amazing. And it just turned out to be a really great fishing day. And actually today, we even wrapped up all our videos on this great local beach here that I have Port O'Connor. And it was just an amazing trip, guys. If you ever are in Texas and you need to go fly fishing, you need to hit up this man. He knows so much about fly fishing. Like, I'm so enriched with just information, everything he's provided, the stories and everything, man. Kevin, you are the legend that Costa was telling me about. I'm really glad you welcomed us here, showed us around everything, and man, it was an unbelievable trip, and I thank you. And you guys, if you ever want to book with him down here, you can go to www.ktdiaries.com. Check out his website. I'm going to throw a link in the description, please. Hit up this man if you need, even just need information. He has a lot of shows and a lot of information. This guy is just a wealth of knowledge on fly fishing and hunting if you're into that. So please hit up this man, Kevin.
Thank you.
It's been a hell of a trip, man. I really appreciate you having us down here. I
appreciate all your words, man. You got one thing left.
I gotta work on my casting.
Well, one other thing. Texas barbecue this afternoon.
That's right, guys. We're gonna hit up some Texas barbecue blacks, right? That's
what Blacks
we're
talking. Barbecue. Black,
apparently the best barbecue in Texas. So me, Chris, and Edward, we're gonna jam up and go get that because we've been waiting to try some Texas barbecue. So guys, we're gonna catch you later back when I'm in San Diego. And Kevin, I hope to see you soon, man.
Thank you.
Thank you. Right. See you guys.